Hello friends, today we will study problem related to 3D transformation. So here is the first problem. A homogeneous coordinate point P, a point has been given whose coordinate is 3, 2, 1. A point has been given whose x, y and z coordinate is given and is translated in x, y and z direction. So the point which is to be translated along x direction, along y direction and along z direction. So translation unit is -2, -2 and -2, means point is to be translated -2 along x direction, -2 units along y direction and -2 units along z direction. So first, translation transformation is to be done in this problem. Second, respectively followed by successive rotation. So rotation is to be done 60 degree about x axis. So second transformation which is to be done is rotation 60 degree about x axis. Next, find the final position of homogeneous coordinate. So we have to find the final position of homogeneous coordinate. So we will start with the solution of this problem. So there is a point, the point which is to be translated along x direction, along y direction and along z direction. And secondly, the rotation transformation is to be performed about x axis by 60 degree. Since it has not been mentioned whether it is to be counterclockwise or clockwise, so default we have to consider it as counterclockwise direction. So now first transformation is translation. So the standard matrices for translation in 3D is given by 1 0 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 0 1 0 tx ty tz 1. So this is standard translation transformation matrix. So for this I will require the value of tx and ty and tz. So in the problem itself, the value of tx is -2, the value of ty is -2, the value of tz is also -2. So now I will replace the value of tx, ty and tz. The matrices will become 1 0 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 0 1 0. The value of tx is -2, value of ty is -2, the value of tz is also -2 and this is 1. So now we found the translation matrix. Now second transformation in this problem is rotation about x axis by 60 degree. First translation and second transformation is rotation. Rotation 60 degree about x axis. So now we will write the standard rotation matrix R, which is equal to 1 0 0 0 0 cos theta sin theta 0 0 minus sin theta cos theta 0 0 0 0 1. So this is the standard rotation matrices about x axis. So I will write as x rx. So now I will require the value of theta. So here the value of theta is 60 degree. So now I will replace the value of theta as 60 degree. So the transformation, that is resultant transformation for rotation, will become as 1 0 0 0 0 0.5 0.8660 0 0 minus 0.866 0.5 0 0 0 0 1. So this is the corresponding matrices for rotation. Now next we will find the resultant transformation. The resultant transformation is the total transformation which is done in this problem. So resultant transformation which is given by TR, first transformation which is done in this problem is translation, and then rotation is been done. So TR, which is equal to, I will write the matrices for translation, which is 1 0 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 0 1 0 minus 2 minus 2 minus 2 1, and then the rotation transformation matrices, which is 1 0 0 0 0.5 0.866 0 0 minus 0.866 0.5 0 0 0 0 1. So now I will multiply both these matrices, then the final transformation, that is resultant transformation, which I will get as 1 0 0 0 0.5 0.866 0 0 minus 0.866 0.5 0 minus 2.732 minus 2.732 1. So this is the resultant transformation matrix. In this problem we have to find the final position. So we have to find the final position. So we know the formula for final position as final position, which is equal to initial position into TR. So we know the initial position of P, which is 3, 2, 1. So now I will convert the coordinate form of P into matrices form, then it will become 3 2 1 1. Now I will multiply it with TR. So the matrices for TR is 1 0 0 0 0 0 0.5 0.866 0 0 minus 0.866 0 0 minus 2.732 0.732 1. So now I will multiply the both the matrices, so that I will get final position, that is P dash. I am representing dash for final position. So after multiplying both the matrices, the value which I get as 1.864 minus 0.5 1. So this is the final position. Now I will convert this final position, which is of the form, that is in the matrices form. So I will convert this matrices form into coordinate form. So I will write as final position P dash, that is converting into coordinate form, which is 1 comma 0.864 comma minus 0.5. So this is solution for the problem. Thank you.